Hey, Hill.
Hill here.
Gaming.
Then the rest is up to me. Are you ready to go? I'm not entirely sure what this thing is going to do when I add my blood.
All right, well, we're about to find out.
Then the rest is up to me. Are you ready to go? I'm not entirely sure what this thing is going to do when I add my blood.
I'm ready.
Okay, here goes.
It's all or nothing now. Let's go. Wait. This isn't working.
Are you all right? That looked painful.
It was. What happened?
Now that I think about it, I should have expected that. Sorry. It's hard to describe. The Soul Cairn is... well, hungry, for lack of a better word. It's trying to take your life essence as payment.
So there's no way in, then?
There might be, but I don't think you're going to like it. Vampires aren't counted among the living. I could probably go through there without a problem.
Are you saying I need to become a vampire?
Not your first choice, I guess.
Nor my last. There has to be another way.
Maybe. We could just pay the toll another way. It wants a soul, so we give it a soul. Yours.
Wouldn't that kill me?
My mother taught me a trick or two. I could partially soul trap you and offer that gem to the ideal masters. It might be enough to satisfy them. It would make you a bit weaker when we travel through the Soul Cairn, but we might be able to fix that once we're inside. Maybe.
Those are my only options.
I'm sorry. I wish I knew a better way, something that would be easier for you. Just know that whatever path you choose, I won't think any less of you. Sometimes things just have to be done. I know that better than anybody.
All right, then.
Yes?
Soul trap me. I won't feel right as a vampire.
Are you sure? I'm willing to do it, but you need to think it through. You'll remain mortal, but you'll find yourself weakened within the Soul Cairn.
I'm ready.
I know this is difficult for you. I hope you trust me. I'd never do anything that could hurt you.
Really? Let's just get this over with.
As you wish. I promise to make this as painless as possible. Hold still.
That's it.
Let's go. My mother must be waiting on the other side of that thing.
No fancy lights? All right, let's go. All right, well, I don't see your mother. It's hard to see anything here.
Ugh, the smell here. Let's try to handle this quickly.
Wait, what's this? Is it supposed to look like this in here? I can't really make much out.
Die!
things.
You must help me find my Arvac. He doesn't deserve to be in a place like this.
Calm down. Who are you, and who is Arvac?
Arvac, my horse. We came to this horrible place together. We were attacked by monsters, so I told him to run. Please, he's such a loyal creature, and he's been running for so long. You have to save him. A place like this will change you.
How can I help him?
Arvac! Arvac! Where are you? Arvac, please come back! Come back!
Until next time.
Air? Ground? This is all wrong.
Yes, it is. Is it really supposed to be this bright in here? Are you?
This place tears at me as though I am still alive and being drawn.
Wait, is that Arvac?
I can't stand it anymore.
Arvac. Right, he's gone. Really having trouble believing that it should be looking like this in here. All right, let's continue to wait. Who are you?
Well, look what we have here. Someone with flesh on their bones.
What's the matter with you?
Let's just say I sold something to a guy who turned out to work for a whole coven of necromancers. How in the name of Zenithar was I to know the ingredients were phony? Do I look like someone that would double-cross a necromancer?
So that's how you got here?
You got it. Horse, wagon, and all. Plopped here without so much as a word. I used to be one of the best traders in High Rock, you know. How people would track me down just to see what I had for sale.
Got anything left?
Very funny.
I thought so.
What exactly are you going to pay me with? Take a look around. Gold doesn't exactly win you any friends around here.
There must be something you want.
I'll tell you what. I appreciate what you're trying to do, so I'll play along. The only thing I see around here in abundance are soul husks. You know, those ugly fungus-looking things growing out of the ground. Bring me, say, 25 of them, and you can rummage through what was left on my cart.
25? That seems like a bit much. What do you have?
Things I've gathered over the years. Well, used to gather, before all of this nonsense happened to me. Tell me what you're looking for, and maybe we can make a deal, if you have the husks.
I don't.
No husks, no sale. Guess you have some scavenging to do.
Stories about the Soul Cairn, but never thought I'd see it myself. So far, it's about what I imagined.
Alright, we're gonna keep heading in the direction of the compass.
Thank you.
if this is something, I can't even tell what it is. It's some big, bright ball of light. I'm not sure this place is supposed to look this way. We're getting close to our goal.
Mother?
Wait, mother? What? You see your mother?
Serana? Is it really you? I can't believe it. How do we get inside? We have to talk.
Serana, what are you doing here? Where's your father?
He doesn't know we're here. I don't have time to explain.
I must have failed. Harkon's found a way to decipher the prophecy, hasn't he?
No, you've got it all wrong. We're here to stop him. To make everything right.
Wait a minute. You've brought a stranger here? Have you lost your mind?
No, you don't...
You, come forward. I would speak with you.
Would you now?
So how has it come to pass that a vampire hunter is in the company of my daughter? It pains me to think you'd travel with Serana under the guise of her protector in an effort to hunt me down.
I'm just here for the Elder Scroll.
Glorious. Serana claims you're her guardian, yet your first instinct appears to be greed. I see that my daughter is still as naive as ever. Serana has sacrificed everything to prevent Harkon from completing the prophecy. I would have expected her to explain that to you.
That's why I'm here for the Elder Scroll.
You think I'd have the audacity to place my own daughter in that tomb for the protection of her Elder Scroll alone? The scrolls are merely a means to an end. The key to the tyranny of the sun is Serana herself.
What do you mean?
When I fled Castle Volkahar, I fled with two Elder Scrolls. The scroll I presume you found with Serana speaks of Ariel and his arcane weapon, Ariel's bow. The second scroll declares that the blood of Cold Harbor's daughter will blind the eye of the dragon.
How does Serana fit in?
Like myself, Serana was a human once. We were devout followers of Lord Molag Bal. Tradition dictates the females be offered to Molag Bal on his summoning day. Few survive the ordeal. Those that do emerge as a pure-blooded vampire. We call such confluences the Daughters of Cold Harbor.
The tyranny of the sun requires Serana's blood.
Now you're beginning to see why I wanted to protect Serana, and why I've kept the other Elder Scroll as far from her as possible.
Are you saying Harkon means to kill her?
If Harkon obtained Ariel's bow, and Serana's blood was used to taint the weapon, the tyranny of the sun would be complete. In his eyes, she'd be dying for the good of all vampires.
I would never allow that to happen.
And how exactly do you plan on stopping him?
I'll kill Harkon.
If you believe that, then you're a bigger fool than I originally suspected. Don't you think I weighed that option before I enacted my plans?
I am Mandrake, the Merciless. No one can stand before me. So what is Serana's option in this?
You care nothing for Serana, or our plight. Whether or not you've become one of us in order to survive the Soul Cairn, you're still a vampire hunter. You're here because we're abominations in your mind. Evil creatures that need to be destroyed.
I'm just here for the Elder Scroll.
I see. You're simply here to stop the tyranny of the sun, despite the cost to Serana. Nothing else matters. This stranger aligns himself with those that would hunt you down and slay you like an animal. Yet I should entrust you to him.
This stranger has done more for me in the brief time I've known him than you've done in centuries.
How dare you! I gave up everything I cared about to protect you from that fanatic you call a father!
Yes, he's a fanatic. He's changed. But he's still my father. Why can't you understand how that makes me feel?
If you'd only open your eyes...
The moment your father discovers your role in the prophecy, that he needs your blood, you'll be in terrible danger.
So to protect me, you decided to shut me away from everything I cared about. You never asked me if hiding me in that tomb was the best course of action. You just expected me to follow you blindly. Both of you were obsessed with your own paths. Your motivations might have been different, but in the end, I'm still just a pawn to you two. I want us to be a family again. But I don't know if we can ever have that. Maybe we don't deserve that kind of happiness. Maybe it isn't for us. But we have to stop him. Before he goes too far. And to do that, we need the Elder Scroll.
I'm sorry, Serana. I didn't know. I didn't see. I've allowed my hatred of your father to estrange us for too long. Forgive me. If you want the Elder Scroll, it's yours. Your intentions are still somewhat unclear to me. But for Serana's sake, I'll assist you in any way that I can.
It's about time. Do you have the Elder Scroll with you?
Yes. I've kept it safely secured here ever since I was imprisoned. Fortunately, you're in a position to breach the barrier that surrounds these ruins.
What do I need to do?
You need to locate the tallest of the rocky spires that surround these ruins. At their bases, the barrier's energy is being drawn from unfortunate souls that have been exiled here. Destroy the keepers that are tending them, and it should bring the barrier down.
We'll return soon.
One more word of warning. There's a dragon that calls itself Durnavir roaming the cairn. Be wary of him. The Ideal Masters have charged him with overseeing the Keepers, and will undoubtedly intervene if you're perceived as a threat.
A dragon. That's interesting. Haven't seen any of those. Why haven't you pursued the prophecy?
Harkon's vision is a world plunged in eternal darkness, where the vampire can flourish. And never again fear the tyranny of the sun. What he fails to realize is how much attention would be called to our kind if the prophecy came to fruition.
What sort of attention?
If eternal night fell, there are many who wouldn't stand for it. They would raise armies in attempts to return things to normal. The order of the day would be our destruction, until every last vampire was hunted down and eliminated.
So, you prefer living in the shadows?
I do. It's how the vampire has survived for millennia, and the only way we can continue to survive in the future.
If I leave the Soul Cairn, can I safely return?
As you've been traveling in the Soul Cairn, your body has become attuned to it. Let's just say a tiny part of you rubbed off on it, and in its place, a bit of the Soul Cairn filled the void. You should find no difficulty using the portal any longer.
How did you become imprisoned here?
When I entered the Soul Cairn, I had intended to strike a bargain with the Ideal Masters, the custodians of this place.
What was the bargain?
I requested refuge in the Soul Cairn. And in exchange, I would provide the Ideal Masters the souls that they craved. If I had foreseen the value they placed on my own soul, I would never have come here.
They tricked you.
The Ideal Masters unleashed their keepers and sent them to destroy me. Fortunately, I was able to hold them at bay and retreat into these ruins.
You became trapped.
Unfortunately, yes. Since the Keepers weren't able to claim my soul, they had their minions construct a barrier that I'd never be able to breach.
You've been imprisoned here for all this time.
Time has very little meaning to me. Consequently, it has little meaning to the ideal masters as well. I suppose you could call this the ultimate waiting game. Each watching the other to see which will give in.
Who are the ideal masters?
I know very little about them. They're mystic entities that lord over the Soul Cairn, controlling every aspect from its fabric to its appearance.
What do they resemble?
Well, some necromancers believe they are the crystalline structures dotting the Soul Cairn. I believe there's more to it than that.
How so?
I think they transcend what we perceive as a physical form. Perhaps they were once corporeal beings, but they've obviously reached a point where they no longer require a tangible presence.
And the crystals?
Conduits, through which the ideal masters speak to their underlings and feed on their victims.
Why would they require sustenance?
The ideal masters' weakness is their insatiable hunger for pure souls. It's the reason for the Soul Cairn's existence, and the only leverage a necromancer has when bargaining with them.
What do the masters provide in return?
The ability to summon powerful undead guardians, as one would conjure an Atronach or Daedra. However, the majority of necromancers that are foolish enough to enter into a bargain with the ideal masters wind up here, as harvested souls.
All right. Thank you for the information. It's time for us to leave.
Be careful, and keep my daughter safe.
I will.
Let's kill those keeper things and get back to the prison.
For now. Let's go.
Oh.
Actually, I can see a little better now. All right, stay on guard. Some more stuff going on up here. Let's see what this is. Ghosts. Huh. Oh, here are these husks, too. Hey, you there.
Get out while you can.
Okay. You don't have to tell me twice. Let's get some of these husks. Or all of them. I wonder if I should try to figure out what this is. All right, it's nothing. Nothing but light. All right, I'm trying to lock onto a position on the compass and stick to it. So much around here to distract me. This looks like a problem. Let's see what's going on. Find Arvak's skull.
For you.
his skull. We'll take this. Right. Completed. I need to return the skull somewhere. This did something to me. I absorbed it. I don't know why I have no sense of direction here. All right, we're going to just keep trying to go straight. And follow the compass that should take us to this tower. Look at this, another distraction. And look at that gem floating up there. All right, who are you? You there!
At least the pain is gone.
That's it? That's all you have to say? Get out. Well, I'll take this money. Wait, what just happened? I wonder what's up with that. We'll come back later. What's this over here? Oh, more soul husks. Serana. There she is. It's about time you helped me out. More soul husks. Getting a little bit closer to one of these towers. Oh, wow. What's this? The Keeper. So is this it? I saw some people up here and now they're gone. All right, we need to find the next tower then. It would be nice if I knew what this was that I was absorbing. Could be something deadly for all I know. Who are you?
Leave me be.
Stay on your...
We're under attack, and I'm taking these husks first. Who's fighting us? We're gonna head over to this tower in the distance. More husks. All right, we've got those things.
Show yourself. I knew I heard something.
There's gonna be a guardian here somewhere. There he is. There. That's it. All right. What's going on over here? Look out, Serana. This is probably part of some quest. Yes, we're going to kill the Keeper things. But... can I absorb this too? Doesn't look like it. Alright, let's go. Who are you? Oh, you're...
What do you want?
What exactly are you doing?
How does anyone expect me to write my opus with all of these rude interruptions?
I don't know. Opus, what do you mean?
What do I mean, indeed? If I hadn't lost all of the pages, I wouldn't be in this predicament. And we wouldn't be having this conversation.
No, we wouldn't. All right, I might as well do this. Let's start at the beginning.
Very well. I suppose a moment or two of my time couldn't hurt. I am Jib. Some call me Saint Jib. Others call me Jib the Eradicator. Perhaps you...
No, I have not heard of you.
I can't say that I'm surprised by your answer. Until I get my second volume published, no one will ever know of my achievements.
You're talking about a book.
A book? I'd hardly call a 26-volume epic simply a book. Surely you've heard of the rise and fall of Saint Jib the Eradicator, hero of Morrowind and savior of the Dunmer.
No, I have not. Maybe a shorter title is in order.
Maybe you should leave the writing to an expert. Stop making foolish suggestions.
How is your work going so far?
Terrible. Simply terrible. I was in the midst of writing the second volume, and they just threw me into this prison. It's unfair.
Who threw you in here?
That damned Remora and his minions. They didn't even give me a chance to explain who I was.
And Remora captured you?
Well, I assume so. It cast a spell at me from some kind of strange black crystal. Next thing I knew, I arrived here.
Your soul was trapped.
My what? Wait. That means...
Yes, that's right. You're dead.
No. All these wasted months, or has it been years? I don't even remember how much time has passed. Now my work will never see the light of day. My name will be forgotten.
I really don't want to, but could I help?
Perhaps. Do you have a way out of here?
I do, but you can't leave that way.
Maybe I can't leave, but my writings can. In order to write the second volume of my opus, I need the notes from my first volume. Otherwise, I need to do all of this from memory.
How many pages did you lose? And I know I'm gonna regret asking this question.
When I was tossed in here, I felt myself falling. And I dropped the pages I had been holding. 10 of them in all.
10.
Find them for me, please. I beg you.
I guess that's better than 25. Alright, let's go.
Thanks again for searching. I don't know what I'd do without the pages.
I don't blame you for sitting down. Let's go, Serana. Maybe I need to stop talking to these spirits. What is this? A soul fisher? What does this do? I harvested a soul. Interesting. Still don't know what this does. Let's hope if I need them for something else later that they'll be available. Because I've absorbed most of these. Oh, there's someone else over here. You. Did we do it? Where are we? All right. Got teleported somewhere.
where's the keeper or the guardian? Now I see what's going on here. Got him. So is this it? Dragon bones. Well, at least that dragon that she spoke of hasn't found us yet. It'll be my first one to fight. All right. It looks like we were successful.
You managed to destroy all three keepers?
Of course I did.
Very impressive.
Are you able to give us the scroll now?
Yes. Please, follow me. Keep watch for Durnavir. With the prison's barrier down, he's almost certain to investigate.
I just had to mention the dragon. Think you could be doing it alone either.
The Elder Scroll is just a bit.
Oh boy. Don't know what would work better here. We'll try our bow. Where'd it go? What the skeletons do? I'd rather have all of them focused on the dragon. Should have known that I wouldn't get the dragon soul. Again, proving that I'm not dragonborn.
Mom, she's leading us to the scroll.
All right, let's go. Thank you.
I never thought I'd witness the death of that dragon.
You look a little pale. Are you all right?
Forgive my astonishment. Forgive my astonishment, but I never thought I'd witness the death of that dragon.
What makes you say that? Do you not know who I am? When I said I was going to kill Harkon, it was no empty threat.
Volumes written on Durnavir allege that he can't be slain by normal means. It appears they were mistaken. Unless...
Go on.
The soul of a dragon is as resilient as its owner's scaly hide. It's possible that your killing blow has merely displaced Durnavir's physical while he reconstitutes himself.
How long will that take?
Minutes? Hours? Years? I can't even begin to guess. I suggest we don't wait around to find out. Now, let's get you the Elder Scroll and you can be on your way.
Books.
What did you want?
They could be deeper.
Yes, all right, I thought maybe I might learn something valuable from the books.
I can't believe we found my mother alive. Well, you know what I mean.
All right, we've got the Elder Scroll of Blood.
I can't believe we found my mother alive. Well, you know what I mean.
Yeah, I get the picture. All right.
Now that you've retrieved the Elder Scroll, you should be on your way. If there's anything I can do before you depart, you must let me know.
Yes. Can you help me get my soul back?
So my daughter applied some of the lessons I taught her about necromancy, did she? Don't worry. I think I can help you.
Good. I could use all the help I can get.
Your soul essence was trapped inside a gem. When you and Serana entered the Soul Cairn, it was given to the Ideal Masters as payment. You simply need to retrieve the gem. The moment you touch it, your soul essence will be restored.
Any idea where it could be?
There's an offering altar not terribly far from here. I'm willing to bet that the gem you're looking for is there. Is there anything else? Could be your last chance.
You're staying here.
I have no choice. As I told you before, I'm a daughter of Cold Harbor. If I return to Tamriel, that increases Harkon's likelihood of bringing the Tyranny of the Sun to fruition.
We may never return.
After what I've put Serana through, I would understand if she never wished to see me again. I leave that decision in your hands. Remember that Harkon is not to be trusted. No matter what he promises, he'll deceive you in order to get what he wants. And promise me you'll keep my daughter safe. She's the only thing of value I have left.
Come on, let's go home.
Did you have anything to ask before you depart?
No, no more questions. And it's not up to me whether or not Serana returns to see you. It's entirely up to her. Let's go.
Is that...
Yes, it is. Materializing again. But we may have gotten it this time. All right, let's go. All right, this is the way out. But we still have some things to do here in the Soul Cairn before we leave.
The sooner we get the scroll home, the sooner we deal with my father.
Yes, but there's some things we need to do here first, and we'll do that next time.